On to race number six, and the sixth on the programme is a Class 2 contest, 1,000-metre dash here, final leg of the Triple Trio. Sees the return of Country Star, been off the track since June. He's a five-time winner of the 1,200 at Happy Valley. Yi Chong Baby, beaten favourite, 3 from 3 this season. Course and distance for the first time. Starling City is a five-time course and distance winner, fresh up since September. Voyage Warriors, 3 from 5 course and distance. A little bit disappointing over the 1,200 last amount. Mr Lumiere, a three-time course and distance winner. Refined Treasure, four-time course and distance winner. Blinkers going for the first time. Multi-millionaire, five-time course and distance winner. Cue the music, up in class for last start winner, Happy Valley. Down to Heart Conquered, who makes his Hong Kong debut. He's a five-time winner out of Australia for Team Hawks. Really good lineup here. Country Star, Starling City and Voyage Warrior are the horses that have been up at Chung Fa within the last month.
And they'll be going like the clappers, the field of 14 here up front. So you've got a lot of pace with Mr. Lumiere, multi-million. He's a very speedy type. He led again at Happy Valley last time out. Voyage Warrior this time out has the benefit of the outside rail from gate 14. Then on the second line, you've got Yi Chong Baby, Speed Vision, who has been weakening in his races. Heart Conquered is interesting. He's got a good record from Australia. Probably have to be a little bit patient with Starling City. You can see Dragon General get back but run on at the end.
Country Star hasn't been down this course in distance before, but he's been placed at Charlton on his one occasion there over slightly longer. He's really allowed to stretch out here, but look, he'll be fresh up this season. Adds another dimension. He's got to carry 133. Yi Chong Baby's work's been very good recently. He's got a good draw as well in barrier number 11. He goes nicely and he stretches out very well. So his work's been good leading into this contest. Jimmy Ting's got him going along very nicely at the moment. And a Voyage Warrior, he's been up in Chung Fa since his last one. The cross noseband will come off him as well. I think he's better down the straight 1,000. He has got barrier 14 as well, so he will be against that outside rail.
All right, OK. Plenty of form to have a look at here, but race number six is also a quartet and first four merged jackpot, so $1 million going in there. Let's get straight into the action then, and we'll start off with Water Diviner, Mr. Lumiere and Little Bird. Now, this is over the 1,200 metres. Fat Turtle in the white jacket wins the race. He's going round in the Group 3 in race number 7.
I wouldn't be put off by having Water Diviner here over 1,000 metres because he has got a decent course and distance record. He's only missed a top three berth on one occasion, always runs a good race. He got a little bit keen and quite awkward near about the 650 or so, but gee, stayed on okay. Of course, Fat Turtle's going around in the feature race on the programme. Thanks River didn't do a lot the other day. Some nice horses going around in that race, and he can bob up from time to time.
Yeah, I think he's been running some really good form races as well, as you mentioned, Water Diviner. And he always plays a good price, doesn't he? When he wins, he always wins at double figures. Look, I found a spot for him. I thought from barrier 12, they'll go really fast, so he'll be finishing off late.
All right, well, he's 8.6 at the moment, so a few other people thinking along the same line. This is Cue the Music winning at Happy Valley over the 1,200, but he's run really well down the straight. He was fourth to Athero on his debut.
Yeah, exactly. And so he's had a couple of runs down the straight. He's run fourth on both occasions. Mr. Lumiere was the other one. Look, they went straight to the front and he led all the way and held on nicely in this race. So it was a good win from him. He's in good form at the moment, so he's definitely another chance in the race.
And they were queuing up behind him over the final stages there. I haven't got him in the top four, but that first run he produced was a beaut.
All right, Yi Chong Baby is next. Now he won. He was unbeaten here in Hong Kong last season, 2 from 2, and he works like an absolute bullet in the morning, but he's been beaten 3 times this season.
Yeah, he won his first two, didn't he, last season, then he did pull up with blood in the track here on that run on the all-weather. Since then, he's run another couple of thirds at Happy Valley, so the races haven't been too bad. With no pressure on him here, he wins the trial really nicely. I just wonder what's going to come under race day pressure. And saying that, he's speedy enough to sort of keep himself out of a bit of trouble, so I still found a spot for him.
All right, so Refined Treasure with the blinkers on. And Heart Conquered, I think this is a really interesting debutant, but it's a really hot race as well.
It is a really hot race. He's quite interesting, isn't he? Heart Conquered, crossover noseband, first time, all five wins, 1,000 metres. Seemed to barrier trial here okay on this occasion. And Refined Treasure had the blinkers on in this barrier trial. I thought they might have sharpened him up, so I'd be worth including him, I think, into the multiples because those blinkers seem to work.
Yeah, and he's a four-time winner down the straight as well.
That Heart Conquered as well. He's by Key Mafido, owned by Panzer Tonga, trained by Richard Gibson. So there's the symmetry with him. Country Star then returns, been off since June.
Yeah, he's been away for a while. This was the barrier trial. Clear Choice was in this barrier trial in the red cap there, and he's come out and won since. This horse was one of the real soldiers for the John Size stable last season. He won 5 from his 10 runs and placed second on a couple of minor occasions. He bled last start. Typically quiet John Size barrier trials there. I'm happy to leave him out this time, but he's at 29s in the market.
Yeah, I'm thinking they might go back to Happy Valley next time as well, and that's where his 5 wins have been.
All right, Voyage Warrior favourite, if you forgive me, his last start over the 1,200 metres. With straight track form's pretty good.
Yeah, it is. I'm going to go with Refined Treasure in this. He's had 4 wins down the straight, 1,000. The blinkers were really good in that trial, and he cantered to the line. So I think this is his go. From barrier 13 as well, we should get a nice run. Water Diviner can be underrated, this horse. But I can see there is market support, as you mentioned, early for him. But I think he'll stay at double figures. In saying that, he does like the straight 1,000. Yi Chong Baby and Voyage Warrior, I'm going to give him another chance as well. He's drawn 14, so he'll be against the outside fence, and I think 1,000 is his go. 8, 5, 3, 6.
I'm with number 5 on top here, and that is Water Diviner. With all that pace in the race, it'll really suit him. He'll be attacking the line at the end, number 5, Water Diviner. Voyage Warrior comes out of a good form race, perfect match, big time baby, a big party all through that race last time out. He's got the benefit of the outside rail. All these horses are drawn wide, in fact, towards the outside fence. Refined Treasure after his recent trial with the blinkers, and Yi Chong Baby from gate number 11. Easy trial win, but we've seen him do that before and fail in the past. So 5, 6, 8, and 3.
Yeah, I thought it was 6, maybe 7 or 8 horses that could actually win this race. We've all got the 3 and the 6 in our numbers as well. So again, maybe hopefully that's a good starting point for you with race number 6, 1,000 metre dash.